since Tip of the Arrow got into full swing in April of 2009, Carl, I think you mentioned it. How many service members have
you? We've placed over 200 service members. And I'd also quickly like to mention that we would not be in the position we are in without Bob Deissig. He offered management, strategy, and a plan to make us successful. I am merely a jobs mechanic.
You can tell these guys don't like each other terribly much.
But he's a good mechanic.
Matt mentioned Chris Tomlin when I interviewed him. And Chris is a staff sergeant. I actually wanted to talk with one of the veterans you've worked with. And Carl, I know he worked with you. He's one of the individuals you helped get in contact with J.B. Hunt. Chris is the father of two teenage daughters. He served in the Pennsylvania National Guard for 8 years. He is attached to the 3rd of the 103rd Infantry Brigade, and he spent 15 months in Iraq and a year in Afghanistan. Here's what he had to tell me about his job search experience in working with you. Chris, thank you for joining me. As your last tour was ending, what were your concerns about finding a job when you got back?
Well, I had almost completed college, and I only had two semesters left, and so I wasn't quite sure what I was going to do. I was a political science and a history major, dual major, and besides getting a government job, there didn't seem to be too many prospects out there. So it really was just a blank slate. I wasn't quite sure what I was going to do as far as work went.
And how did you first find out about Tip of the Arrow?
Tip of the Arrow had reached out to my local company in Williamsport, Pennsylvania, due to the gas drilling that had started to boom about 2 years ago in that area. And there are many security companies opening up business there. And Carl was looking for veterans more along the lower levels, like from the ranks of the privates, just to be your local security for the companies that were bringing their equipment in. So he reached out looking for veterans, and my company had reached out to me, giving me Carl's number. And that's when I first got in contact with Tip of the Arrow.
What happened next?
Carl told me about the job as a security guard, and he had asked me a few questions about my background. And when he found out that I was a staff sergeant, had leadership experience, I had a college degree, and that I also had some work experience, he told me that I was way overqualified for the position he was looking for, but he would like to do an interview with me to dive into my background a little more. So 2 days later, I spent about an hour and a half on the phone with him, telling him all about me and what I had done. He immediately said that I needed to come to a job fair that he was putting together at Fort Dix, New Jersey for veterans. I set that up, and a week later, I was in Fort Dix, and there were over 70 prospective employers there. I had originally gone there with the intention of finding myself a government job, but Carl was able to direct me to many other employers besides just government jobs.
What kinds of companies?
He had directed me toward Prudential, a few transportation companies, including J.B. Hunt, who I now work for. There were some other various small companies in there besides AT&T and Prudential. There were some local contractors from New Jersey. There were some oil companies that were looking for management type of prospects. So there were many different companies there. They were looking for everybody with different degrees.
Mm-hmm. What was it like to work with Carl? What was it that he did, aside from introducing you to potential employers?
Well, Carl has a unique talent. He has the ability to help you describe yourself using words that you would never use on your own. And I think one of the problems that veterans have, people in the services, is that we do some things that would be considered incredible by the regular public. Because we're so used to doing those things, we don't consider them to be anything extraordinary. Carl helps you bring that out in your resume and in your interviews. Ever since I met up with him, he was on the phone with me until I found a job pretty much every day. And he still calls me all the time, even though I've been hired. But Carl sits down with you. He gets into great detail with your background, everything that you've done in your life, and he's able to take all your experiences and put them into words, like I said before, that you would never think of using on your own. He has a way of putting your entire life down on paper and making it sound extraordinary.
Mm-hmm.
That's Carl's unique talent. And it's really everyone at Tip of the Arrow, not just Carl. Carl just happened to work with me one-on-one, but Bob and all the other volunteers there, they have the same talent. And that's really what they're doing is they're helping veterans describe themselves on their interviews and in their resumes, which really projects the way that they ought to be describing themselves and not the modest way that veterans have a tendency to do.
And I understand that that's one of the main difficulties most veterans have.
It is absolutely true, because how do you describe to a regular employer what the value is in riding around in a vehicle or walking on a patrol in Afghanistan, taking contact from an enemy? What types of skills do you develop when you do things of that nature? But really, it's not much different from what we're doing now in the sense that I'm in a management position and you have the same type of pressures, although you don't have the exact same dangers that you have when you're on a deployment. You do have those similar pressures on you, and being in the military helps you deal with those pressures that a regular civilian would not be used to dealing with. And therefore, we're able to jump into a high-pressure job like a management position, and we're able to deal with those pressures very effectively. And Carl helps you translate your experiences into the words that match more what a management company or any other company out there is looking for.
You mentioned that you were hired by J.B. Hunt, the transportation company. I believe you're based in Albany now. What exactly is it that you're doing, Chris?
I'm an operations supervisor, so pretty much in charge of all the operations that go on in the terminal as far as putting together routes for the trucks to drive each day, making sure the warehouse is effectively moving product in and out, and just in charge of the everyday maintenance of the vehicles and getting along with all the drivers, making sure they're being taken care of, directing the safety culture that we have in our company.
If I remember from your background, you at one point in time were employed as a truck driver, and yet J.B. Hunt was not one of the companies that came to mind when you were looking at the job fair.
Yes, during our interview, I had gone over everything with Carl that I had done in my life, and he happens to be very good friends with Matt Kaczynski, who is the head of the Human Resources Department at J.B. Hunt, and he was at the job fair that day. So Carl was walking me around to all the employers that I had skipped at the job fair that he felt I should have gone to. J.B. Hunt was one of those employers. Carl probably took about an hour to an hour and a half of his day just to walk me around and talk me up to all the employers he thought I would match mm-hmm. well with. When we got J.B. Hunt, he had spent about 15 minutes with Matt just talking about me. And at the time, I wasn't even thinking about transportation. It just made sense to me after talking with Matt and Carl that it was the perfect career for me. So I pursued J.B. Hunt as an employer. I continued to stay on the phone with him, and Carl was on the phone with me every day. We were practicing interviews. He was telling me exactly what to say. We had some mock interviews that mm-hmm. we did. He was able to find me this job here.
I understand that you're going to be redeployed again around the end of the year, which will be your third tour of duty. Will the job be there when you get back?
Yes, it will. J.B. Hunt is a very pro-military company. They have many veterans. As a matter of fact, my boss is a veteran as well of two tours. They actually go above and beyond in the sense that if I make less than my yearly salary while I'm deployed, J.B. Hunt will make up the difference. So Carl and Tip of the Arrow track many pro-military companies that do exactly the same thing that J.B. Hunt's doing with me.
Based on your experience, Chris, what advice do you have for other returning veterans as they do their own job searches?
Get in contact with Tip of the Arrow. They go above and beyond. They do more as a volunteer company than most for-profit companies do when you're measuring the effort that they put in towards getting veterans jobs. They're incredibly enthusiastic. And Carl has been doing this his entire life, as well as Bob. And they're just experts at what they do. They motivate you as a soldier and as a civilian to go out there and find a job. And they help you every step of the way. I couldn't recommend a better company for placing veterans into employment positions.
Great, Chris. Thank you very much. Come back safely.
Thank you.
I really enjoyed my conversation with Chris, and he could not say enough good things about what you guys are doing for him and his fellow service members. And it's pretty indicative of what I've seen trolling around on your Facebook page, on your LinkedIn page, and on your website.
The comments Chris made were about me, and I'm, you know, totally humbled. But Bob does that day in and day out with multiple servicemen, has the same or better effect, and that if you had spoken to 30 or 50 or 80 other veterans who had dealt with Bob, they would have the same things to say about him that Chris was kind enough and Matt was kind enough to speak about me.
We only have a couple of minutes left, Bob, but can you talk a little bit about where you get your funding?
We've gotten several small grants from Novartis, the Achilles Foundation, and most recently we partnered with JVS and JVS, two other nonprofits, and submitted a proposal to the Kessler Foundation, which we found out in January that we were the recipients of. What that will allow us to do now is to work with disabled soldiers, specifically those with traumatic brain injury, other cognitive impairments, and mobility disabilities. It's a two-year grant. At the end of it, we're obligated to recruit enough veterans to place 40 a year for the next 2 years. JEVS and JVS will provide the training for these veterans, and we will be working with them on outreach programs to find internships and jobs for them at the completion of that. But we're still looking for additional funding.
And how many other people do you have doing what you do in working with the returning veterans, and where do you find them?
Well, we have a volunteer core of HR professionals. We've had as many as 45, but you know, as volunteers, you know, some come, some go. So yeah, we've got a base cadre of about 15 volunteers that are working with us on a consistent basis. I know we're short of time, but we could not have done this without some other folks. You know, our military advisors, Colonel Polinsky at Fort Dix, Major John Moyer, who recently returned from a deployment to Iraq, and Sergeant Major Clark, and Cheryl Curtis, who is with the Garden State Chapter of Sherm, has been very instrumental in our formative period in bringing coaches to us through her contacts with Sherm. So all of them have done a great job in supporting us in our mission.
Well, thank you both for being here today, and thank you for what you're doing. And thank you out there for listening. You can learn more at tipoftheArrow.net. The foundation is also on LinkedIn and Facebook. Or you can go to the links on the DIY World Improvement Radio Show Facebook page. And I hope that you will join us next week.
Well, I had almost completed college, and I only had two semesters left, and so I wasn't quite sure what I was going to do. I was a political science and a history major, dual major, and besides getting a government job, there didn't seem to be too many prospects out there. So it really was just a blank slate. I wasn't quite sure what I was going to do as far as work went.
And how did you first find out about Tip of the Arrow?
Tip of the Arrow had reached out to my local company in Williamsport, Pennsylvania, due to the gas drilling that had started to boom about 2 years ago in that area. And there are many security companies opening up business there. And Carl was looking for veterans more along the lower levels, like from the ranks of the privates, just to be your local security for the companies that were bringing their equipment in. So he reached out looking for veterans, and my company had reached out to me, giving me Carl's number. And that's when I first got in contact with Tip of the Arrow.
Deissig. He offered management, strategy, and a plan to make us successful. I am merely a jobs mechanic.
You can tell these guys don't like each other terribly much.
But he's a good mechanic.
Matt mentioned Chris Tomlin when I interviewed him. And Chris is a staff sergeant. I actually wanted to talk with one of the veterans you've worked with. And Carl, I know he worked with you. He's one of the individuals you helped get in contact with, J.B. Hunt. Chris is the father of two teenage daughters. He's served in the Pennsylvania National Guard for 8 years. He is attached to the 3rd of the 103rd Infantry Brigade, and he spent 15 months in Iraq and a year in Afghanistan. Here's what he had to tell me about his job search experience in working with you. Chris, thank you for joining me. As your last tour was ending, what were your concerns about finding a job when you got back? Since Tip of the Arrow got into full swing in April of 2009, Carl, I think you mentioned it. How many service members have
We've
you?
We've placed over 200 service members. And I'd also quickly like to mention that we would not be in the position we are in without Bob.